Good morning, students. Okay, up to now we have studied the heating effect of electric current, and from the last lecture we have start new topic, that is the magnetic effect of electric current. In that we have studied that due to the passing of electric current, magnetic field is generated around an electric conductor. And generally we know magnetic field is a field which is present around the magnet. Okay, such a way that I already told you. Suppose this is one bar magnet, then this bar magnet around that, such a way we represent this field with the help of magnetic line of forces. Okay, so this is the magnetic field which is present around and bar magnet. Okay, so such a way that if, but in case of this example we are already studying, we take one cardboard and we take some iron filling here. Okay, now we have randomly placed all the iron filling on this cardboard, but when we pass through current through this wire of copper, okay, at that time we have see that all this iron filling are shape them such like circular path. Okay, they arrange them in a circular path. So we know iron is the strongly attracted by the magnet. So here what happened? Due to the magnetic field present around this wire, this electric wire, what happened? This iron filling are arranged then itself in a circular path around the conducting wire. So this is happen due to the production of magnetic field around an electric conductor, that is the this wire. Okay, so such a way that I already told you electric field and magnetic field are, before 18th century they are considered as the two separate things. Okay, but now after the experiment of Oersted, if through that electricity and magnetism are the two, are not two different parts, but both are the one part, both are the two sides of coin. We can convert electricity with the help of magnet, and also we can produce magnetic field with the help of electricity. Okay, so both are the same thing, not a separate thing. So that is combinedly they called as a electromagnetism. Okay, so such a way that only one thing here we have to remember. Okay, magnetic field is no doubt about that, it is a field which is present around the magnet. Okay, but we can create such a field in surrounding current carrying conductor. Okay, no doubt about that, magnetic field is a field present around the magnet, but the same thing we can generate around the current carrying conductor. Okay, around the current carrying conductor we also generate magnetic field. Properties of both the magnetic field are same. Okay, both are magnetic field, properties of both magnetic field are same. So same case we are generate in this current by using current. Okay, we not need here magnet. Okay, but by the using current we can generate magnetic field, because around current carrying conductor this magnetic field is present. Okay, and I already told you the meaning of this circular arrangement. Okay, so as we know, as we go away from the center of the circle, okay, so here we will find that the at near the wire, okay, near wire the concentric circles are much close to each other. Okay, but as we go away from this center, okay, that we are go away from this center, as we increase the distance from this wire, then we will say that distance between the two nearer circles should be goes on increasing. So its meaning that distance increases means strength of magnetic field decreases. As we go away from the electric conductor, at that time max strength of magnetic field goes on decreasing, and near the electric conductor this strength is high. Okay, so on only one thing we have to remember, this magnetic field and this magnetic field both are similar. Around an current carrying conductor, magnetic field is generated. Okay, moving charges if are present there, then around that moving charges magnetic field is generated. Also properties of the both, that is the bar magnet and this magnetic field, will be same. How that also we have to see what happens if you take a coil of current carrying conductor at that time, what happens, what will be the current, what will be the, how much magnetic field generate in case of coil of current carrying conductor. Now suppose another one point we have to see, we see that if we take a magnet, then we represent this line are the magnetic line of force. Okay, so and we are also are already told yesterday that the direction of magnetic field in the bar magnet is north pole to south pole. Okay, north pole to south pole is the direction of magnetic field. Now here in this case, which is the direction of magnetic field? Okay, here not a two poles are present, so we cannot say exactly from this direction to this direction is the magnetic field direction. So here we have to use one rule to find out the direction of a magnetic field, and that rule is right hand thumb rule. Okay, so to determine the direction of magnetic field in this case, we have to use a rule which called as a right hand thumb rule, which told us that we have to catch a conductor such a way that our thumb directed towards the direction of current. Okay, so suppose here this is a current carrying conductor and this is the direction of current. Okay, downward to upward, so we have to catch this current in our right hand such a way that this thumb is represent the direction of current. Okay, so I already told you this is the our direction of current in upward direction, so we have to place our thumb or catch this conductor such a way that our thumb should be represent the direction of current. So this is the direction of current if we catch a conductor such a way that thumb is represent the direction of a current, then direction of curl fingers. Okay, so remaining curl fingers direction is represent the direction of magnetic field. Okay, so simply right hand rule tells us that suppose this is a current carrying conductor, then we have to hold current such a way that our thumb represent the direction of current. Okay, so this upward is the direction of a current, then I place my thumb in the direction of current such a way that at that time the remaining fingers, which is curl, that represent the motion of the magnetic field, the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so this is the direction of the magnetic field. Now we see the statement of this right hand thumb rule. Now we have to see the right hand thumb rule. Okay, this right hand thumb rule, I already told you, it determines to denote the direction of the magnetic field. If there no two poles are there, okay, we know in case of bar magnet we represent magnetic field, magnetic line of force start from north end and ends to the south end. Okay, but now in this case here not a present of south and north pole, at that case how we have to find out direction of magnetic field, that we can represent with the help of right hand thumb rule. Okay, so in this case what we have to do, generally if we see first statement, if we catch electric current in our right hand and point our thumb in the direction of current. Okay, first of all, suppose this is a one electric conductor and electricity is passing through this conductor. Now we have to catch it in right hand side, but such a way that point our thumb in the direction of current. Okay, I already told you, suppose we have to consider this current is a pass through in this direction. Okay, so we have to catch this electric conductor in our right hand, okay, such a way that our thumb should be in the direction of electric current. This is the direction of electric current. So we catch our thumb such a way that our thumb points the direction of electric current. Then the curl fingers around the conductor. So the remaining fingers are curled around the electric conductor, and this direction of curl fingers denote the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so this is the statement of right hand thumb rule. We can find out the direction of magnetic field here by using this right hand thumb rule, because here no south pole and north pole are cases. In this case, if we know the direction of current, because here what we have to do, no doubt about that, we have to hold this conductor in right hand, but we should know the direction of current, and then we have to place our thumb such a way that it is in the direction of current. If we don't know the direction of current, then in which direction we have to place our thumb? Okay, so because here that is important point, we have to place our thumb such a way that it should be in the direction of current. Okay, so for that we should have to know the direction of current, then and then we can easily find out the direction of magnetic field. So this statement also we have to remember, right hand thumb rule, which tells us that if we catch electric conductor in our right hand side and place the thumb such a way that it is in the direction of the electric current, at that time the curl fingers denote the direction of the magnetic field. Simply this is the statement and this is the rule that we have to use to find out the direction of magnetic field which is generated around an electric conductor. Okay, now we have to see magnetic field around a loop of current carrying conductor. Loop means, or simply, we have to make a one current carrying wire and take large number of turns of that wire, and by taking large number turns of that wire we have to making this loop. Okay, so this is the loop. Here we connect it to the battery. Now electric current is passing through this current carrying conductor's loop. Loop means simply what, we have to consider only large number turns of a current carrying conductor. If you pass the current through the large number of turns of a current carrying conductor coil, okay, at that time what happened, that we have to see. Now here we connect this loop to the battery, okay, and we consider here two points, point P and point Q. Now if you consider each and every point on this loop, okay, then we will find that each and every point we will find such a case. Okay, we know if you consider each point of an electric conductor, suppose this is point P point, okay, and this is point Q. Now at point P we know current passing through point P, due to the passing of current around point P, magnetic field will be generated. Okay, so we represent that magnetic field such a way that, okay, also we consider a point Q. Okay, here again what happened, magnetic field generate around the point Q, and we represent such a way that magnetic field around point Q. Now we consider any point of this present on this loop. Suppose here somewhat point present, then around that point such a way we can represent magnetic field present. Okay, so we represent here only two point, okay, and there we can show the magnetic field present around the two point, such a way that if we take any point of this loop, then same case we will find there. Okay, such a way that magnetic field will be present on that every point of this loop. Okay, so on each and every point we will find similar structure on this loop. Okay, so such a way that magnetic field generate around each and every point of this loop. Here only we show example of two points, but actually magnetic field generate with around each and every point of this loop. So here, if we say that magnetic field generated by the one turn. Now here, what we consider, we take large number of turns of wire. Okay, for that we have to consider now if here only one turn is there. Okay, so if only one turn is there, then the magnetic field produced its will be certain somewhat value. Okay, and if we take large number of turns, okay, look at what we do in case of loops, we take large number of turns. So first of all, we consider only one turn, and suppose in one turn, suppose we have to consider magnetic field is M. M is a magnetic field which is generated due to one turn. Okay, then in case of loop, we take large number of turns instead of one turns. Okay, suppose we have to consider n number of turns we can take here. Okay, n number of turns of the electric wire we take here. Now at that case, how much magnetic field will generate here, that we have to see. So m is a magnetic field due to the one turn. Okay, then if we take n number of turns, at that time magnetic field around that loop will be equal to n into n. Okay, if n is a magnetic field due to one wire, okay, only one turn, and if n number of turns are there, then the number of turns into magnetic field due to one turn is the total magnetic field around this current carrying loop. Okay, from the formula we can calculate that total magnetic field around this loop will be equal to magnetic field due to one round. Okay, magnetic field due to one round into number of rounds. Okay, instead of loops we have to write here number of rounds. How many rounds of wire we are taking, that here we have to multiply. So if n number of turns, okay, n number of rounds of wire, then magnetic field will be equal to n into magnetic field due to one round. Magnetic field due to one round. So here, whatever the magnetic field generated by one round, only we have to multiply how many turns we consider here. Okay, if you consider the 100 turns, then will be 100 into magnetic field due to one round. Okay, so such a way that magnetic field around an electric current carrying loop is calculated. How? Magnetic field due to one round into total number of turns. By using this formula, we can calculate total magnetic field around the loop current carrying conductor. Okay, that much part we have studied up to today's lecture. Now from tomorrow we will start the magnetic field around the solenoid. Okay, solenoid is simply what? It is a straight current carrying conductor, and we will make it in round shape. At that time, that shape will be formed, which is simply called as a solenoid. We will see it in next lecture, but first we have to see how the right hand thumb rule we have to use. It is used to denote the direction of the magnetic field around the current carrying conductor, because in this case we don't have south and north pole. So in this case we have to use right hand thumb rule, but for that we should have to know the direction of electric current. So we have to place our thumb in the direction of current, then curl fingers will denote us the direction of magnetic field. And here the magnetic field around a loop carrying conductor, we have to consider here one loop. Loop means simply what? Large number of turns are there. In that case we know due to the each turn magnetic field will be produced. So total magnetic field produced by the loop will be equal to magnetic field due to one turn. Okay, that is the one loop into total number of rounds, total number of loops that we have to consider. Simply by using it we can calculate the total 90 field around the loop. Okay, so this is all about the today's lecture. Remaining part of this chapter we will see in tomorrow's lecture. Thank you.